This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we welcome Chef Amar from India. We have an India restaurant, of course. We have a great recipe for Bengal fish curry. It's actually going to be featured as part of Jubilee, right?
That's right.
Now, take us through the ingredients that we need. I see a lot here. I'm smelling a lot of wonderful
First,
things.
I want to share with you why I picked this.
Okay, yeah.
It's really nutritious. It's really fast to cook, and it is delicious. You know,
Perfect.
This is something that I fell in love with completely, and I proposed to it, but it doesn't talk back to me.
Well, you got a good partner there. Okay, so this is great, I think, for those busy families that are on the go. If you want something
Absolutely.
Healthy and easy to make, this is it. So what do we
I'm
need?
Using the Atlantic pollock, which is the cod family,
mm-hmm.
except it's more flavorful, but it's very delicate fish, cooks really fast.
Okay.
And it's we call it Bengal fish curry because in Bengal, which is just above Bay of Bengal, there's a lot of seafood available. And Bengal fish curry is very well known all over India, you know.
Okay.
And the ingredients are, this is panchpuran, which is a blend of five spices
mm-hmm.
Right here. And it's got mustard seed, fenugreek seed, cumin, nigel seeds, and I forgot something.
That's all right. We'll figure it out for ourselves. And a whole lot of other seasonings. Quickly, let's get to those.
Okay. What I made a blend of spices, which
mm-hmm.
which consists of equal quantities of cumin powder, turmeric powder, and chili powder, and sea salt.
Okay.
So this way, it makes it easier to make the dish.
Nice. Tomatoes, garlic,
and
peppers.
Another very
everything.
Important ingredient is curry paste, which is made mm-hmm. with fresh curry leaves here, ginger, garlic, jalapenos,
okay.
and cilantro with some canola oil.
Beautiful, and we yep. have some rice to pair with it as well. We're going to get this dish started in just a bit. Speaking of fun, let's go back into the kitchen with Will.
We got a lot going on. Thanks, Michaela. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Amar is here from the restaurant India. And what are you going to be doing right now?
I am going to be making Atlantic fish curry. It's actually Bengal fish curry. I'm using Atlantic cod.
Okay.
Atlantic pollock, which is a cod family.
And you've got it chopped up into smaller pieces.
I have taken a fillet and I've cut it into smaller pieces. And because the fish is very delicate, and when I'm cooking it, I'm going to gently lay it down in the sauce.
Sounds good to me. It smells spectacular in here from all of the spices. We're going to turn over to this lady here, Brooke Fairman from Rhode Springs Park Zoo. You are in
yes.
charge of development. You are the lady who's going to give us all of the information about Jubilee, which anyone out there who has not been to Jubilee, it is a great event with a ton of restaurants from mm-hmm. all over the state.
Yeah.
And it's a lot of fun for everybody, too.
Yeah, this year it's our 23rd annual Jubilee Feast with the Beast. It's an adult-only event,
right.
and we have, you're able to actually wine, dine, and dance among the animals. This year we actually have over 50 restaurants.
What you were telling me earlier is a record for Jubilee, correct?
It is a record for Jubilee. We have many coming back for the 20th year, some for our 10th year. That
right.
would be India here. We have a new Zucchini list.
Nice.
We have the Red Line. We'll be featuring the Red Line Band, and of course for opening we're going to have the farm dog band, which is our in-house employee band. So that's very exciting. We also, our auction this year, our online auction is very special. It has a football from an original football from a Super Bowl signed by Tom Brady.
That's big stuff.
Yeah, and we have a very wonderful jack-o'-lantern experience that will also include your very own carved pumpkin.
So if anybody wants to get tickets to the event, want to find out more stuff about how you know what's going to be auctioned, what do they need to do?
Here's what you need to do. You need to bring your friends. You need to tell your friends.
Yeah.
You need to go to rwpzoo.org after you get your babysitters.
Sure.
And you need to find all the information there, and that will be, I promise you, it will be the best part
well,
of the
it
year.
Well, it's a lot of fun. We've been in years past. It's always a lot of fun. You get to see a lot of people who you may not see throughout the year. There's great restaurants there, and always a good time with, you know, dancing and fun and laughter. So if you want more information about that, you can follow those directions. We are going to get back to cooking in just a little bit. Back to you. Good stuff. We are in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Amar is here. India is the restaurant. Bengal fish curry is on the menu, and he's going to be one of the restaurants featured at Jubilee that's coming up in just a couple of weeks. He's ready to cook. He's taking phone calls from agents in the meantime while he's cooking. He's done so well. What are you going to do right now?
Yeah, but phone calls should be after the cooking show, you know.
Yes.
I just dropped a few drops of canola oil.
Okay.
And the oil has to be really hot. I'd already heated the pan.
And do you prefer canola oil over like an olive oil for a recipe like this?
Yes, for this purpose. What I am going to do is heat the pan and then add some of these panchpuran seeds that I mentioned in the recipe. They're sizzling. It's very important for them to sizzle because then they impart the flavor to the dish. And I'm going to drop a couple of curry leaves. Mm-hmm. These are fresh curry leaves, and I'm going to press them against the pan. And as you can tell, it's you can smell
so
that.
Good.
Yes. And then I'm going to add some chopped tomatoes.
All right. We'll get this fan going here so we can see you there, Chef Amar. Man, the fragrance is from all of these spices that you're cooking
And
with.
This is the curry paste I talked about earlier. And you drop a couple of teaspoons.
Uh-huh.
And as you mix it, you have to make sure that the flavor of everything blends in together.
Right.
So mix it all together. And this is the blend of spices I showed ahead earlier. And I put some of the spices in there.
That's beautiful.
And you add some water, otherwise it's going to be too dry for it to cook.
Okay.
So, mix that through.
Yeah.
Make it into a sauce. And let the sauce cook just for about 30 seconds or so. You know, that's why it's important for the pan to be hot.
Right, okay.
You know, drop a little bit more water.
And while you're doing that, let's talk about the restaurant, too, because it's a great restaurant. I mean, it's been around for such, you know, for a long time, and you have so many different flavors. And any of the food that you guys cook has all of these spices. It has an intense flavor to it.
That's right. But this dish is unique in a lot of ways because we use a lot of onions in our sauces. This dish doesn't have any onions.
Okay.
And also, the curry leaves imparted a very distinct flavor.
They all smell great.
And the reason I picked this dish again is because it's quick to prepare.
Right.
And it is very nutritious.
Okay.
And also just excellent, like really tasty.
And tell everyone again what type of fish you're using here and how'd you...
I'm using Atlantic pollock, which is of the cod family. And it's known to be more flavorful than cod.
Okay.
I'm going to add some cilantro to it also. Fresh cilantro.
Cilantro is always good on everything.
Yeah. And you lay down the fish in there and make the temperature a little lower and cover it.
So what are you going to serve this with? I noticed that one of the finished things here is just white rice, correct?
That's right. Because the dish is so fragrant, you don't need any flavor in the rice. So basically what we did was just boil the basmati rice.
Okay.
Basmati rice is known for its natural fragrance.
Right.
And it's very delicate and long.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to cook it carefully, but it's very easy to prepare. You basically take one portion of rice and two portions of water and let it cook on a low heat and until the rice absorbs all the water and you see holes forming in the rice.
Right.
And then it's ready to serve.
And that's when you know it's done. All right,
give
us quickly the location of India.
India is located on Hope Street in Providence. We've been there about 18 years. And the gentleman with me earlier was AJ. He's been with me about 20 years.
Look at
Great
that.
Guy.
So these guys know their stuff. He's going to let that simmer. We're going to show you the finished product in just a little bit. And don't forget, you can get the recipe for this and information about Zubali. All you got to do is go to our website, roadshow.com.